Yo, what is up, guys? It is the Ultimate Frozen Fan back here for another video. Guys, I know it's been a long time, but I don't know if you knew, but I'm a working man now. Got myself a job and graduated college and been real busy with work that just don't have time to make YouTube videos like I used to. I still do live streams with my buddy James from 420 Gaming and make unboxing videos of stuff I get and all that, but haven't really had any videos to like sit down and talk and explain like stuff like that. So I'm gonna try and get some videos out of the way today now that I'm home alone for a little while and have some time to record. The first one is one that I've been wanting to get out of the way for a long time, and it's like way overdue. It's going to be my review of Kingdom Hearts 3. So we're going to talk about this game, what I thought of it, if I thought it was the best Kingdom Hearts game and my favorite, all that stuff. But I will be sparing you the details of the story because we all know the story and it's so convoluted, that's a video in itself. So I'm just going to talk about what I liked, what I didn't like, and my like overall impressions of it, and where it stands for me on the level of which Kingdom Hearts games I like the most. So without further ado, here we go. Let's get started. So first off, the new worlds that we get to explore, Pixar worlds, Toy Story and Monsters, Inc. You know, everybody was excited about having Pixar worlds for the first time, and so was I. I thought they were great. They were a lot of fun to play in. Did not, however, care for the Gigas in the Toy Story world. They were just all over the place, too many of them, and if you didn't have a Gigas yourself, then you pretty much, wouldn't be hard to take them down, and they'd pretty much kill you usually, so didn't really care for that aspect, but I did like the Toy Story world and the Monsters, Inc. world. Then we also had the return of Olympus, which was fun to actually be able to explore Olympus and Thebes and climb the mountain and fight all the Titans this time, not just two of them. And they actually followed the plot of the movie, so that I really liked that. That was a lot of fun. Then we had some the return of Pirates of the Caribbean, which I wasn't too crazy about, but no, I'm sorry, guys. I did not like the Pirates of the Caribbean world. It was too big. I did not enjoy all the ship combat of sailing the ship. It was kind of hard to control at times and had to keep firing the cannons, and it was probably the longest, biggest world in the game, and the story was kind of interesting. I'd never seen World's End, so, you know, I didn't really know, like, what to expect. Okay, the story, I liked the story for the Pirates of the Caribbean game. It was very interesting, and I guess it was fun to, you know, like, fight the Kraken and fight Davy Jones and stuff like that, but for the most part, probably my least favorite world in the game. Then we get to other newer Disney properties like Tangled, Big Hero 6, and my favorite, Frozen, Arendelle. So, We'll talk about Arendelle last, because I know that's everybody's least favorite world, probably. But for Tangled, for the Kingdom of Corona, I gotta say, the plot holes really bugged me. It just really didn't make the story make sense. I was sad that we didn't get to go visit the Snuggly Duckling. Then things that happened in the movie just suddenly happened with no explanation, like Flynn going to return the satchel when there were no Stabbington brothers to return it to. Then Rapunzel suddenly calling Flynn Rider Eugene, and Eugene automatically knowing that her hair had healing qualities. And the biggest one that, well, two of the biggest ones, the one of them is that how Rapunzel got the satchel when Mother Gothel had it the whole time. I mean, I guess in defense you could say all this stuff happened on screen when Sora gets separated from Rapunzel and Flynn, but it still makes for plot holes and doesn't really make it make sense. But then we don't know how in the heck Flynn managed to escape from being hanged with just Maximus. We didn't have the Snuggly Duckling thugs, so I liked the Tangled world. I liked, like, the environment and the games and the bosses and everything. but I did not like the way the story was handled. They just cut out way too much, and at that point made the story suffer a little bit because it just didn't make sense. Big Hero 6, on the other hand, that was a lot of fun, but it was so, so massive. It was a huge city, and it gives me some idea of what it could be like if we ever have a New York City for, like, a Marvel-themed world. So, but it was cool getting to fight the original Baymax in evil form, and had a totally original story, and then Sora and Donald and Goofy becoming Keyblade Hero 3, and then seeing Evil Riku and the Bug Blocks and everything. That was a blast, and still can't get over the fact that there's two Baymaxes now. So that's going to be pretty interesting if they ever expand on that, either in the movies or the TV show. But there's that. And now on to my favorite world, Frozen Arendelle. It was my most anticipated and most wanted world for the game, and I kept watching all the E3 and D23 trailers, seeing if they would reveal it, and they never would. It would be like Olympus, then Kingdom of Corona, Big Hero 6, Toy Box, Monsters, Inc., and I started losing hope that it just wasn't going to be in there, even though I was like, it's going to be a huge missed opportunity for Square Enix. And then, last year's E3 came that glorious reveal trailer, and I had a freaking heart attack and lost my shit. You can check out my reaction video. I'll put the link at the end of this video and in the comments and the description down below, so you can check that out. And I know a lot of people didn't like the fact that you would fall off the mountain and just keep climbing back up and that, but I was able to get past all that. Learned my way around the mountain pretty quickly and managed to get back and everything. And it was so cool to see my two favorite franchises together for the first time, Frozen and Kingdom Hearts, and Sora interacting with Elsa and Anna and Kristoff, Sven and Olaf, and their shot-for-shot remake with a few new angles and adding Sora, Donald, and Goofy into the mix of Let It Go. That was glorious. I loved that. It was so, so beautiful, and seeing all the different angles that Sora, Donald, and Goofy, like when they see Elsa make the ice castle from the outside, that was fantastic. So, and then getting to team up with Marshmallow, that was super cool. And I had a blast in Arendelle. It was my favorite world. It did not disappoint. Like I said, it was my most anticipated, most wanted, and I really loved it. Keyblade Graveyard was expanded on a bit, so that was nice. And then we've got the new final world where we collect the Phantom Soras, as well as Scala ad Kylum, where the final battle takes place, which was a beautiful place. I can see why it's Tetsuya Nomura's favorite world. Just too bad we didn't get to explore it. We only had boss fights in there, but maybe with DLC we'll get to explore it or something. So that takes care of the worlds. Now let's get on to the gameplay. So new gameplay mechanics that were added were obviously the Keyblade transformations, the attraction flow rides, and what else? So like so much stuff that's because we already had links and summons in previous Kingdom Hearts games. So what else did they add that was new to the team attacks? Maybe no, we've had team attacks before. Well, the biggest things were the attraction flows and the Keyblade transformations. Now, I really liked a lot of the Keyblade transformations. They were a lot of fun to use, and they were flashy and cool. And of course, my favorite was the Crystal Snow Frozen Keyblade, because Sora would be using the ice blades to attack, and then at the end he stomps on the floor and makes Elsa snowflake, and then recreates her chandelier, climbs up it, and throws it down. Those were some great callbacks to Let It Go again, so like that. It's cool, wielding a big hammer, and then like two like pistols and a bazooka, all kinds of creative stuff like that. The rides were a lot of fun to use. I unfortunately didn't get to ride any of those rides when my family and I went to Disneyland. There just wasn't enough time, but they were a lot of fun to use. Then some of the mini games. I enjoyed the Lucky Emblem hunts. Those were a lot of fun. Just because it'd be like it's like right in the corner of your eye, and you just keep completely missing it, and it still was. It was a lot of fun. I like the new gummy ship building section. I made a lot of custom ships. Those are here on my YouTube channel, so you can check those out too. I enjoyed the Flantastic 7 mini games, with the little pudding heartless, as I like to call them, which kind of replaced the Mushroom 13. My favorite was probably the ones that you just bounce on while trying to avoid getting eaten in San Francisco, the Honeydew Flan. And my least favorite was the Banana Flan, that where I have to take out the little ones while trying to avoid getting eaten by the big one. Because it's just such a small space that while I'm trying to avoid it, I end up doing slow motion and kept getting eaten. I was cursing like a sailor doing that challenge, but I found the best thing to use was both the Mirage Staff Keyblade as well as Thunder, and that finally did the trick after maybe like 20-30 tries. Sora had a lot of cool new abilities that I enjoyed using, like some of his like counterattacks, like reprisals they're called, and then all kinds of cool stuff, flashy effects and stuff like that. And although I gotta say, I did not really care for the classic Kingdom minigames. I only did those for the completionist in me, for Kingdom Hearts, to complete it 100%, but I was not a fan of those at all. I honestly don't see what the point of having them in there was, other than to get the trophy and to get a new Keyblade, which is basically the same as the Toy Story Keyblade. That was another thing. A lot of the Keyblade transformations and shot locks were about the same. Well, not about that, but some of them were very similar to each other. Like for example, comparing the Shooting Star and the Honey Gear, I can't remember what it's called now, but the 100 Acre Wood Keyblade, they're both the same in terms that they have a bazooka and dual pistols. The Monsters, Inc. Keyblade and the Toy Story Keyblade are very similar to the Big Hero 6 Keyblade, because you can make a yo-yo, a hammer, and stuff like that out of the little nano arms coming from the Keyblade. The Crystal Snow, I don't think there was anything that was the same as Crystal Snow, but I don't think Mirage Staff, that's the only one where you can create mirages of Sora and then make a big tower and just obliterate everything. So it'd take too long to compare them all, but you see what I'm saying. So I did start noticing that as I unlocked more Keyblades. I'm like, hey, this transformation is just like this one. So, I gotta say, I wasn't really a big fan of the 100 Acre Wood. I mean, the puzzle bobble mini game was fun. It's just too bad that was all we got to do. We didn't get to explore more of the 100 Acre Wood. And I do not care for the new Winnie the Pooh cast at all. I miss all the old ones. It's too bad that they've passed on and are no longer with us. My least favorite would probably have to be Rabbit. I just do not like Tom Kenny as Rabbit. I just don't think he makes a good Rabbit at all. Ken Sampson was, he was the one. He did the best Rabbit. Piglet's not too bad. I like Piglet. Who else has passed on? Peter Cullen as Eeyore, he passed on. So now they've got, I think, Bud Lucky, did the clown in Toy Story 3, and I forget who else he played in the Pixar Disney universe. But anyway, So I liked the games in the 100 Acre Wood. I just didn't really care for the voice acting and the fact that it was so small. So there was that. The cooking minigames with Remy, it was cool to have Ratatouille in there, but some of them were kind of frustrating to the point where it's once again the completionist in me trying to complete them all just got so frustrating, and I found a workaround because whenever you lose a minigame, you lose those ingredients. So if you run out of ingredients, you gotta go collect them again. And some of them were such a pain in the ass to collect because you had to fight the flams in order to get some of them. So what I did was I saved when I had a bunch of ingredients and then would go to Remy's. And then once I've used up all my ingredients, just restart the game and load up the saved game to before I lost those ingredients and keep trying until I got it. I honestly am not a fan of QuickTime events. I've always sucked at QuickTime events, and that's kind of what these mini games reminded me of, especially like that egg cracking one where you just gotta very gently push away the control sticks and then make sure you get it in. And I was also shooting for an excellent on each game, so you can imagine what that took. What other one didn't I like from the flambe one? Wasn't too bad, you know, he's pouring the sauce in, you just gotta time it right because then it's gonna blow up. So timing, that was the thing that I could never get right, to get an between a good and an excellent. So what other one didn't I like in there? I like the chopping one because that one's just fast chopping, and then you just move on to another one, chop. That one was easy. The spices one, with the switching between the from one hand to the other, of salt or pepper, that one got hard because in order to get an excellent, you had to time all of them just right, and it just, they were frustrating. I didn't really care for them too much, so, but the battle portals were fun. To fight enemies and level up and that, and then when I finally got the Ultima weapon, holy cow, that's got to be the best Ultima weapon we've had because of Ultimate Form. It's so awesome seeing Sora be surrounded by all these different blades just raining down, and they're all multicolored and everything, and then the shot lock of creating a freaking huge beam of light up in the air and everything, that was just fantastic. In terms of music, the music for Kingdom Hearts is phenomenal. I love the music. It had some great remixes of old Kingdom Hearts themes, as well as the themes for the Disney World. I thought they fit really good in with the environment. Thought they were really good. And then, of course, having the Frozen music in there of Let It Go and Build a Snowman. I love that. And the graphics, oh my god, the graphics are freaking beautiful. It's great seeing everybody in a new HD remaster, because they've never been on a system like this before, full-on remade that way. I mean, the original Kingdom Hearts games were for the PlayStation 2, and then we had some for the DS, and one for the PSP. And so, you know, the graphics, you know, aren't as good as they are today, you know, back then. And they did remasters to remaster them in HD, but you know, they still look the same, just with better color and sharper quality and everything, but they didn't go back and completely remake the games. But I would like it if they could do a remake of 358 over 2 days and recoded for the PS4, same way how they did with Dream Drop Distance. That was, because that one just looked beautiful too, so... And honestly, I'm sorry to say that because Kingdom Hearts 3's graphics were just so beautiful to look at and just so cutting edge and over the top to the limit, it's going to be kind of hard going back to those previous Kingdom Hearts games' render effects, you know. So I haven't really gotten back to any of the Kingdom Hearts games yet, still Kingdom Hearts 3. Kingdom Hearts 3 is one of the few Kingdom Hearts games that I completed 100%, and it's the only Kingdom Hearts game that I've played on every single difficulty. I spent months and months playing this game. I literally just stopped playing it, took a break from playing it about a month ago to start playing some PS2 games, going old school on the PS2, but for the most part, Kingdom Hearts 3 was the only game that I would play. And I'm currently in the Kingdom of Corona on critical mode, and hoping to finish that up. And boy, let me tell you, Critical Mode. People were complaining that Kingdom Hearts 3 was too easy and wanted a challenge. I hope they got the challenge that they were looking for with Critical Mode, because that shit is hard. So, yeah, so, I guess to a sense, Kingdom Hearts 3 was a bit easy, even on Proud Mode. But that didn't necessarily bother me, because I've never really been a fan of the super, super hard Kingdom Hearts difficulties, because I just wasn't good enough. I never really played them, that much. I had a hard enough time on normal mode in Kingdom Hearts 1 for the PS2, as did everybody else. That's probably, to this day, the PS2 Kingdom Hearts 1 is probably the hardest Kingdom Hearts game. At least I think. So what is the verdict? Well, honestly, guys, I would have to say that Kingdom Hearts 3 more than met my expectations. It exceeded them. I was not disappointed, even though a lot of more people were. I couldn't really find a lot of faults with the game that destroyed the experience for me. The story-wise, maybe a little bit too slow-paced, or, like, not they rushed too much at the end, and just, like, stuff like that, but didn't really bother me all too much, and this game, I think, was well worth the wait. I have really enjoyed it. I'm going to enjoy playing it even more when they bring out the DLC. Like I said, I'm currently doing the Critical Mode here and there, but honestly, guys, I would have to say that this Kingdom Hearts game is by far my favorite Kingdom Hearts game right now. I freaking loved it. I loved pretty much everything about it. I had a blast with it. I was the only game I played for a while, and just all the new mechanics, the Unreal Engine 4, and the graphics, everything. I just can't compliment this game enough. I just have almost nothing but positive things to say about this game. Like I said, I know my buddy James from 420 Gaming was a little bit disappointed with it, as well as many others, but I was not. It did not disappoint me. I loved it. I'm looking forward to the DLC. And like I said, it's going to be hard to go back to the old Kingdom Hearts games after playing through Kingdom Hearts 3. So, like I said, I had a blast with this game. I loved it. It was well worth the wait. It exceeded my expectations. It was great seeing my two favorite franchises together for the first time, Frozen and Kingdom Hearts. And yeah, so I would say that for me, Kingdom Hearts 3 is the best Kingdom Hearts game in the series so far, and it has by far become my favorite Kingdom Hearts game in the series. So, that's me, guys, the guy with the unbiased opinion towards a lot of the things that I like. What everybody else hates, I end up loving. That's just me. I don't know what to tell you. People hate Sonic 06. I love Sonic 06. I have an unbiased opinion to it. I love that game. I couldn't bring myself to hate it. People hated Sonic's new redesign and the plot of the movie, everything about the new Sonic movie. I didn't care. I was excited. I thought Sonic looked fine, and I've been waiting for the Sonic movie for a long time, and so I have an unbiased opinion towards that. A lot of the new, like, Disney movies and stuff, remakes and stuff. There's just a lot of things that I like, and that a lot of things that people hate, or that they say I should hate, I can't bring myself to it. I don't conform with the rest of them, because I like the franchise enough that I can appreciate, what they give me and everything. So yeah, guys, I am one of the few people who really, really liked Kingdom Hearts 3, and actually probably one of the only ones who think it is the best Kingdom Hearts game and is their favorite Kingdom Hearts game. So, well, that's it, guys. About 25 minutes in, I knew this video would take a while, because I wanted to sit down and really talk about my experiences with Kingdom Hearts 3, what I thought about it, and let you guys all know that this is by far the best Kingdom Hearts game, and my favorite one, in my opinion. So, Well, that's going to do it for this video, guys. If you made it to the end, congrats. Thank you for staying with me through this. This went on a bit longer than my Sonic 06 review. That was about 23 minutes, but when I talk, I tend to talk a lot, and it just get lost in the time and everything. But thank you, guys, if you watched this video, and if you enjoyed it, hit that like button. Be sure to let me know in the comments what you thought of Kingdom Hearts 3. Did you like it? Did you hate it? Share this video with your friends, and subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any more videos. And until next time, guys, this is the Ultimate Frozen Fan, signing off. Peace!